Request, how can we do that? The question is, we are going to find the area of the square, and we are given that the rectangles inside, they all have the same area. So now let's take a look. We only know this right here is 2, and then we have to find the area of the square. Well, to find the area of the square, we must have the side times the side, right? And because I don't know what the side right here is, so let me just put down x right here. And of course, that will also be x. And just a small note, real quick. Once that's x, the whole area is just going to be x times x. And now it's x squared, so x to the second power. All right, now here's the deal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 rectangles, and they all have the same area. The total area is x squared. So we just have to divide it by 5. That means this right here must be x squared over 5. Likewise this, likewise this, likewise this, and also likewise that, x squared over 5. Awesome. Now, what though? Here's the deal. Because we have the number right here, right? This is the only given number. So we must somehow use it to figure out what x is. And we know this area is x squared over 5, this is 2. So if we can figure out this side from here to here, then we can set up an equation. But how though? Now check this out. This little strip right here, right? This is just like, you know, the driveway of the building, something like that. It's x squared over 5, right? 1/5 of the whole square. So that means the whole thing left right here must be what? Just 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 of this together. So the red part is 4x squared over 5. Yeah? Now check this out. Because we know from here to here is x, and this right here is 4x squared over 5. So from here to here must be equal to what? Well, just do x squared divided by x. We have x, and then we still multiply by 4 over 5. So this part must be 4 over 5x. Just a quick check. If we take this times x, we do get 4x squared over 5 for the red part. And now we have this times that must be equal to this. So we can set an equation. 2 times 4 over 5x must be equal to x squared over 5. And now we can just work this out. So this is like 2 over 1 times 4 over 5, so this is 8 over 5x equals x squared over 5. Multiply both sides by 5. Now just let me show you, so they cancel. And we have 8x equals x squared. And then we can put this to the other side, but let me write this down first. So x squared minus 8x equal to 0, and then factor on x. So that means x is equal to 0, or x minus 8 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 8. Of course, we have a geometry question. If x is equal to 0, we don't have a square. So not this. We want x is equal to 8. So the area must be equal to 8 squared. So the area is 64. So that's it.